let's start from the beginning. You were a child prodigy.
Yeah.
Have you got any idea, has it ever influenced you as a grown-up?
Well, it certainly puts you under pressure at first, because I think there is nothing more fascinating than a young person playing extremely well. But at some point you have to shift your thinking towards artistry, not only playing well.
How old were you when you got your first Stradivarius?
Well, I was very fortunate to get a very good Stradivarius at the age of 13.
That is crazy, isn't it?
It's not unheard of. For instance, Yehudi Menuhin got also his first Stradivari when he was like 11, 12. A lot of, you know, very good violinists who were also very young were fortunate enough to get one of those instruments. But it was on loan. It wasn't my instrument. I didn't buy it. But still, it was a big honor at that age, of course.
So tell me more about your current violin. Some musicians have names for their instruments. Do you have one for yours?
I don't.
You don't want? How come?
A violin.
But you spend so much time with it. How come you don't have a name for it?
Because I consider myself sane.
That's a good answer. So you consider yourself sane, but also a rock violinist.
Well, that doesn't necessarily contradict. I guess you have to be very aware of choices, even when you perform rock music. Same with classical. I think every music genre demands for very clear choices. And so you have to have a strategy, and it helps if you have sane thoughts.
So rock stars are known to be doing crazy things.
Yeah.
You've been involved in a few scandals yourself. Do you want to explain to the Estonian public?
No.
But if I made you?
Sorry, no, there's no way.
Let's move on.
Back to the music.
Okay. So rock stars have got a pretty crazy lifestyle, and they are pretty crazy on stage as well.
Well, please continue. Sorry, I didn't mean.
How is your stage presence? How do you describe it yourself?
Well, I describe myself as a musician, as somebody who takes music serious, as somebody who has a lot of respect for the composers, no matter if they're classical or if they're popular rock, pop composers. For me, it's very important to be integer, you say in Germany, to have a clear understanding of what is happening in the music, what was meant with the song or with the concerto. And for that reason, I also got my music education in order to not only understand on the outside the meaning, but also how the piece was constructed.
Fans recognize you all over the world, or do you have some places you can be incognito as well?
Oh, listen, in the end, it's a beautiful thing if people recognize you, because it also says something about that you have achieved and accomplished something, and you've reached people with your music. And for that, I'm extremely proud. But of course, there are places where it's less recognition, and there are some places where it's a little bit more.
So Estonia is a very small country. The stars here have fans that go to every concert they have. Do you have a fan that you see in every audience?
There are a few faces which I recognize, especially in the first couple of rows. There are people who come more than once.
So you have a concert coming up in Tallinn very soon. How excited are you?
I'm super excited. I actually remember playing in Tallinn. It's probably over 20 years ago. And it was, I think, the Four Seasons by Vivaldi, as far as I remember correctly. But it has been a very, very long time. And this time we're playing with my band, and it's going to be a crossover show with lots of pieces also from the new record, Rock Revolution, some pieces also from the old record, Explosive. So it's the first time I'm going to be performing crossover here, and super excited to, see all the people who hopefully show up. And by the way, the concert is on December 9th, so I'm very psyched to be coming back here.
So one last question. What is your writer conclude of? Like, what's the special thing you need behind the stage to be a rock star on the stage?
I don't need anything but my instrument, because in the end, you keep calling it rock star. You know, for me, and I think for everybody who considers themselves a serious musician, no matter what genre, can be also rock and roll. For me, the most important thing is to have concentration, to be very aware of what I'm playing that night, meaning to be disciplined, which again is no contradiction.